The Pit's disclaimer. Reactions on this channel are opinion only. Our opinions are our own. It doesn't mean we are right or wrong. It's just an opinion. So don't take what we say too seriously. We are not professionals, vocal coaches, or musicians. We do this for fun and to learn new music. Bowzer, spoil.
This is older. Bad meets evil. Hell, the sequel. This is the deluxe edition. This isn't the fucking screw around edition. This is the deluxe edition.
This is the, you get the digital download, the cassette tape, the CD, the Blu-ray, and the fucking vinyl.
And you get the panties. I really honestly don't know what to expect here. It was kind of, you know, what I did is I went back through a bunch of old videos. Man, you're a popular man. You're vibrating over there.
Well,
you got like vibrating panties on. So, I went back through some old videos. And I'm like, let's do a little digging. So this came up a couple times, and
an old recommendation, huh?
Yeah, where it has like the little, they always put the little fire. Oh, you won't be disappointed.
Yeah. How many times have we heard that? Now, I got to admit, I'm in a tough mood tonight.
Ooh.
Real tough mood. So I'm telling you, this has to be older because Eminem did a bunch of crossovers. Like, well, I guess he still does, but they're more like featuring other artists now than they are an actual different name. Like, D12 was one of the other, you know, collaborations and stuff. Now this is Bad Meets Evil.
See, you really don't hear. See, like, all, like, his music's, like, even, like, he's, like, the underground now. Like, everybody, all the mumblas are taking over.
He's not underground now. He'd be old school.
Yeah, this is amazing. This is old school. He's old school. People don't listen to this anymore.
And what we thought was old school was actually, like, ancient school now.
That's,
like, we are way past that.
Mm-hmm. So, this is, like, in between, maybe.
I hope this is cool.
I hope so. Let's move up our setup. I got to turn ambient on. Are you ready?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I'm on. How are you feeling tonight? Are you
I'm all right so far.
I think you're just well broken in, you know? I think that's what that is.
What do you mean? Anyway, Eminem sounding a little weird lately. Sounds different.
Uh-huh. His panties are probably on too tight.
Somebody's angry.
He's
coming in
there
with that angry sound, that agitated sound again.
It didn't open the way that I thought it would, which is good because I thought he was just going to like come in angry straight off the bat, not just kind of like fade in gradually like
see,
that.
See, with Eminem, he starts out, you know, kind of nice and then starts getting a little bit more agitated. Like someone's like
nice,
looking at him, giving him my eye in the studio. And it's just,
Like he's just sitting there getting hungry or something.
Kind of different. It has like a rock sound almost to it.
Not like, what was that song? Cypress Hill, Rock Superstar.
Never heard it.
That's a good tune. Not as rocky as that.
I'm trying to think.
Not as Bullwinkle as that either. Who is this other gentleman that's with him?
That's Big D.
D for Detroit.
Yeah, that's Big D.
Who is it really though?
I really don't know.
Bad and Evil. So he's calling himself Bad. M is Evil.
Maybe it's Dad. D is for Dad. I don't know. Those are some nice shoes he's got, though.
You wish you could afford those.
Well, I could. No. Many moons ago, so pretend my dick is a balloon and blow. But you better put a fork in it if you think I'm gonna lay here just spooning, yo. Oh, you think you the shit because I just said you was beautiful. Got molecules to my last molecule, down to my last half molecule in the cuticle. Riding to the core, to the bone, crawled all the way down to my soul, from my head to my toe. Ever since I was 13, I learned how to sew and so shut my own booty hole. Because I ain't took no shit since I looked down at my nuts. Hold on, whoa. Did he say something about his first pubic hair?
Yeah, I think so.
He looked down at his nuts and he saw his first pubic hair grow? I'm pretty, yeah, I had to back that
up. No, I'll give it to him with this, with the, you know, he's doing lyrically. He's, you know, with the whole Rubik's Cube, you know, doing that with one hand. His life is complicated. What was the other thing? He said something about laying there spooning, but put a fork in you instead because they're done. You know, implying that. Yeah.
He's very good with the words.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I'll be on Spotify and I'll be like listening to some like new hip hop channel. And I'll just be like, ugh, this is not good. And then I hit skip. I'm like, none of these are sounding good.
Eminem song.
But like if this popped up, I'd be like, yeah, all right.
I got to say it's for what it is. That's pretty good. But no, I'm ready to hear this other guy already.
Yeah, where is he? I ain't took no shit since I looked down at my nuts and saw my first pubic grow. I told these stupid hoes when I come back, I'ma set this bitch on fire. And this time, what I mean, I'ma pour gasoline on some chicken lighter. Is this time, I'ma fuck this world, I'ma put the whole goddamn dick inside her. I ain't even put my tip in that hole yet. I'ma go get nickel and try to rip it wider.
Who is this doing the interlude? Like the sounds like that singer from that band In This Moment, in a way, kind of like, ain't it?
No.
Or no, I don't want to say Flyleaf.
Where is your research device? Huh? Something's really missing. We don't even have the research device
right here.
God.
I'll have to phone a friend option.
That's hey, about all you're getting out of that.
Tell me this. Tell me about this song.
I like to phone a friend. Yeah, this is totally different. Well, I mean, I guess I really don't know because I don't listen to a lot of Eminem. So
you listen to more Eminem than I do.
I don't.
You do.
I really don't.
You do.
I don't.
Fuck. Okay, you don't.
All right.
Hey, it's the other guy's turn now.
Huh?
It's the other guy's turn now.
Well, he's good. Bad as I need a horn, stabbing my clavicle bone, I'm matted or prone. First time I seen a desert eagle, I was letting the fofo bust, the fofo pop. First time you seen when you see Goku Puffs, looking at RoboCop. I'm not a man, I'm a logo, I'm a such thing. In order to clean my veins, you need saline. I'm never referring to the solution I'm talking about, more like the Mustang. Vroom. Give respect from the Goku, step to the echo. Pen got a mind of his own, gotta write my rhymes with a timer, otherwise I'll probably vibe out to a 9-minute song. As the echo follows the Maserati, as it petrol swallows, I'm a thousand
to say this guy's an elephant. I'm fly like I'm killing the scene like I'm a villain with wings. I sleep when I'm 6 feet deep right now. I'm living a dream.
So he's got a different style. Not bad, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But what he's doing is, in contrast to Eminem's short little, like, quips of, you know, he'll sum something up, you know, he'll just, like, put it out there, like, real quick.
Yeah.
This other dude, Bad, is...
Bad.
We'll call him Good. Let's call him Good. I don't like Bad. That's pretty fucking negative, you know? I don't want to be negative tonight. All right,
this is Good.
We'll call him Good.
Good D.
Good D is... He's like...
Oh. That came out wrong.
He's kind of like building it more, you know. He's got like a little bit more of an elaborate setup,
mm-hmm.
and then he'll deliver, you know, the line that ties it all back together.
Yeah, Eminem, he could say like two or three words, and it's like, oh, wow, that was clever.
Yeah, yeah. So, but like I said, by no means is that saying that Good D is less clever than Evil M. It's just saying it's a different style. And he's got a different drum, too. It's like, he's got like a different, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Oh, God.
That's what you're just doing. You're going like, yeah.
Was I really doing that? Yeah. Shit.
Unreal.
Fuck.
Man. You need a minute?
Nah, I'm good after last night. Though we may be reckless, the ladies check us, they whisper, shady record. Baby, let go!
Ooh, this would be a good beatbox.
Drum solo.
Huh.
Okay, your mission for the rest of the week is to practice that outro.
On a beatbox?
And beatbox it.
Oh my god. That'd be fucking cool.
That would be kind of cool. That was interesting to have an outro like that as well, you know, just have it fade out. So I think the thing about it was Good D was echoing what Evil M was saying in spirit, just from a different perspective. What it struck me as. No? Yes?
You know, I'm going to be honest. Hmm? I really don't know what it was about. I don't have the research device.
This would be the section of the video where I pulled out the lyrics. Do I really have to fire it up?
Well, I mean, you could fire it up on, you know, on the DL over there.
This is going to be this is all coming right out of the taxes. This is a whole tax write-off right here. I'll tell you that much. I'm gonna get a hold of my accountant.
Okay. Oh, look at that. You just opened it up and it's already... Oh, what are you looking up?
I was listening to Rage Against the Machine's Flaming Monk, quote, self-titled album from 1992. Full album. Fucking great album.
Yeah, it was. Speaking of that, are we going to pull up the lyrics before we say bye? Or, yeah, let's just see what it's about.
Echo, bad meets evil. And where is Genius?
Uh-oh. There it
Genius.
Is.
Genius.com. All right.
We're going to be awfully smart after this now. So
let's just cheat here. It's the last track on the album. Bad and Evil's names are echoing around the world after this great collaboration. Okay. That was a corny description of the song.
That was the explanation, huh?
Ever since I was 13, I learned how to sew and sewed my own booty hole.
Because I ain't took no shit since I looked down at my nuts and saw my first pubic grow.
That was a part that you picked up on, yeah.
That's fucking...
So that's a cool way of saying he hasn't been taking shit his whole life. He didn't take shit from anybody, though, his whole time.
Dude, imagine, say you're at work and be like, man, I haven't taken... I saw my own booty hole. I haven't taken a shit. I haven't taken no shit in like 13 years. Since my last pubic grow.
So if your booty hole, you ain't going to be taking a shit. You know there are some people out there in the world right now. We are so old. You've heard the expression when you say sticking feathers up your butt does not make you a chicken. You've heard that old saying, right?
No.
Get the fuck out of town.
Have you?
Fuck. Well, never mind. So anyhow, apparently this young lady is Liz Rodriguez. Good who's old singing Liz. That? Who the hell is she?
She is born in Toronto. Oh.
Okay. This is now Bowser's Research Pit. Doesn't say anything. Okay, it's not who I thought it was. All right,
just
cool.
A singer. Anyway,
cool story.
Yeah. So
that's it. There we go.
It was just them talking, you know, talking about how they don't take no shit.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
He eats wrappers and consumes them and doesn't shit them out because he sewed up his booty hole.
Anyway, that was our first video of the night. I'm sorry it sucked ass.
It did not suck.
No, not the song. Our reaction to it.
No, our reaction was fantastic.
Was it great?
It was stellar. Wow. Wow.
Woof.
Woof.
We gotta go.